It was in the town of Jacksboro in the year of 33 when a man by the name of Kriegel come stepping up to me saying, "How do you do, young fella, and how would you like to go and spend the summer pleasant on the range of the buffalo?" "Well, it's me being out of employment," told Kriegel, "I did say. This going out on the buffalo range depends upon the pay. But if you pay good wages, transportation to and fro, I think, sir, I might go with you to the range of the buffalo." "Oh yes, I pay good wages, transportation to and fro. If you'll spend the season through on the range of the buffalo. But if you do become a homesick, and to your sweetheart you must go, I'll not pay transportation from the range of the buffalo." "Well, our outfit being ready, boys, seven able-bodied men, with many a six and needle gun, our travels did begin. The way it was a pleasant one, the way we had to go, until we crossed Pease River, boys, in the range of the buffalo." "Well, now we've crossed Pease River, boys, and our troubles have begun. The first damn tail I went to rip, that's how I caught my thumb. The water salty as hell's fire, and the beef we could not go. And the Indians waited to pick us off in the range of the buffalo. Well, our hearts were cased with buffalo hocks, and our souls were cased with steel. The hardships of that summer would like to make us reel. While skinning the damned old stinkers, our lives they had no show. But the Indians waited to pick us off from the plains of Mexico. Well, the season being near over, boys, old Kriegel, he did say that the boys had been extravagant and were in debt to him that day. We begged him and we pleaded, but still it was no go. So we left old Kriegel's bones to bleach on the range of the buffalo. Well, now we've crossed Pease River, boys, and homeward we are bound. No more in that hellfire country will ever we be found. Go home to our wives and sweethearts and tell others not to go. For God's forsaken the Buffalo Range and the damned old Buffalo.